Hello everyone, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. It is Francesco here. Today, we're diving into Llama Life. And you're probably wondering, like, why are you finding these very obscure applications to review, Francesco? Well, this application is particularly interesting to me because at the moment we're in the background working on a focus application, which I won't tell you many details about just yet because it's probably going to be later in the 2021. However, they're sort of interest to me at the moment. I find them to be companion applications to what we're already doing with to-do list apps. And I thought I'd check out this one called Llama Life. The main reason I'm sort of jumping on this now is because they've recently added a Todoist integration. So the concept behind Llama Life is that it's aiming for you to focus on your work in, for example, smaller stint periods. It's basically a timer combined with a micro to-do list application. To be honest, I like the concept. There are a few flaws in it that I'll be going through in today's video. However, I'm mildly impressed with its first take on what it's doing. Now, as you can see here, it does things like task timer, emoji grouping, and some of the sort of alarm-based stuff. And as you can see here is what it looks like. We'll be diving into it in a moment. But before we begin, of course, I want to talk about the pricing and availability. Now, this is the pricing. It's an early adopter pricing of $29.99 a year. In my opinion, too overpriced. It should probably sit at like $14.99 per year at what it is. However, obviously that's, I'm looking into pricing at the moment. It's something that's really quite hard to hit. We recently did doing a video, an article about premium pricing in productivity applications, if you'd like to read it. But it's always hard to price it, but I think they've overshot it by roughly 50%, which is a bit of a pain. And they're only available through this sort of like web application. So here it is. What you can see here is what will appear on the screen. Obviously, enlarging it like this if you want to, but it looks better when it's sort of this format. It does look better on Chrome, just to be clear. And as you can see, it's very simple and it sort of looks nothing too extravagant. But the basic premise of it is you can add tasks below here, add nice emoji to it. For example, if you were like, you could be like, clear emails. And as you can see, the timer is populated at the top. So you can start the timer. And as you can see, you can add a nice relaxing music in the background. So there is that sort of like very similar Pomodoro concept inside of it. And you can see that the timer starts bringing down it. What I quite like about it is it gives you down the bottom its list time, 24 minutes, and the end time that you'll be finished at, based on you going back to back with them. Now you can clear all if you want to, so you can just clear all your tasks for the day, but it is very much, I don't think it brings over tasks from the previous day. However, you do get a report at the end of the day, seeing how much you completed and the summary of time that you've done inside of Llama Life. So I would say there's two additional features that may be more interested in this. I'll touch on more of the details. It's the Todoist integration. So I've connected my Todoist account, and what it will do is it will bring in, it will load any preset tasks inside of Todoist onto the Llama Life setup. So you can see here that I've got to script the walling course and record. Maybe this will take a little bit longer, so I can add 60 minutes to it, and I can move the position of these guys, and I can start the timer based on it. And obviously things are going and rolling. Now, as you can see, super basic. There's nothing really much more than that in terms of what the application does. There are some micro abilities, like being able to modify some of the settings. So if you go over to settings, you can do things like take the Pi timer off. You can see here, it looks slightly better with, in my opinion, without the Pi timer, but that's because I'm not as sort of visually led. Smart time detection. Numbers entered into the task title will cover to a duration in minutes, and you can see the default time as well. They've got some soundscapes and some chimes of when you're setting intervals, for example, when you're coming to an end, and an alarm as well. And you can also see an auto nag. When the timer is up, the alarm will play once every minute, and you can reverse the order of your tasks if you do want to. So some of the basic sort of settings are there. The other thing you can do is if you didn't want to bring in the Todoist integration, you could, I created this one a moment ago, if I press edit, say I want to do a week review, these are three tasks I can bring in. You can add any more, you can delete the preset, remove the duplicates, and I changed them, for example, email 15 minutes, Todoist 10 minutes, journal 5. And what I can do is if I press load, you can see there it automatically starts loading up the tasks that I can do. So It gives me an idea, okay, I'm going to finish at 1:30. I could start going through these tasks. So it's very much a focus application at that. And you can see here that this is the account plan. And as you can see here, you can hide any completed ones and you can clear the completed if you want to. I don't have any at the moment. But as you can see, really super basic. I quite like the ability to create a preset in terms of like, you know, bringing up all of your tasks is a really nice. But my problem is for example, let's say you were buying this plan to, you know, like load up your Todoist tasks for the day. If you loaded up your Todoist tasks, yes, it's really handy because it's being able to see it in a different type of view. It's a companion application, but you're paying only $6 less than Todoist. So your overall to-do list application budget is roughly, if you're paying for the annual plan of Todoist, coming up to $66 just for your to-do list application experience. So I think it's overpriced, but at the same time, these applications are evolving pretty fast, and there might be more features coming soon. But I would say this works on its own as a fairly good sort of to-do list application, as a sort of focus application. Obviously, the thing that I'd say is that you'd have to look into whether this is more suitable for you or not, because some people don't tend to work better with companion applications. They like having simple to-do list. But the other major flaw is that whilst all of these Todoist is available on all of these other applications, this is only available through the web browser at the moment, which sort of is painful because you want to be able to get this potentially on another device. Naturally, you can't, which sort of sucks. You know, if this was on mobile devices, I think it would go down very well at a $14.99 pricing per year. But they're my early opinions on this application. So obviously not as sort of positive as I normally am with applications, but at the same time, I think this application's got a place. I think it's going to evolve. And obviously when it releases mobile applications and reduces that price, maybe I think they'll start to really gain a lot more traction. But interesting that we're reviewing Llama Life today. These application names are getting crazy. My editor said, does this one make a llama noise when you take a note? Just because they're getting crazy. I think people are running out of app names, but it's quite good to see anyway. But folks, I hope you enjoyed today's video. Please do make sure to subscribe, and I look forward to hearing from you all very soon. Cheerio.